We are Ceres Greenhouse Solutions.
Ceres Quality Greenhouse.
We build quality.
Quality.
We are Ceres Greenhouse Solutions. We design and build strong, durable greenhouses for year-round growing that don't rely on fossil fuel heating and cooling.
We do the poured concrete base. There are a couple of different options in the foundation. This one right now has a full foundation wall underground that goes 36 inches, and then it has a concrete slab in between those in order to make it sort of clean and easy to wash. Some people have natural interior. These are 2x4 steel and 2x2 and 1.5x1.5. These are designed to be able to lift pretty easily so that people with some construction experience will be able to build this themselves.
It's a great kit for DIY builder with a little bit of experience or contractor of your choice.
The first thing that we do is go through the packing list and make sure that everything that was supposed to show up showed up. The next step is to lay out your walls on the slab or on the foundation wall. It's always a good idea to place your materials when they arrive close to the build site. And it's also nice to not stack the pallets because it's much easier to access them if they're laid out individually instead of on top of each other.
Generally, the frame arrives first, and then sometime later, maybe a week to a couple weeks, the insulated metal panels and the glazing will show up a little later, and that's the skin around this steel frame.
So once you've unpacked your material, you lay out the base plate pieces where they belong according to your specific plans, at which point you begin by hammer drilling and anchor bolting through the pre-drilled holes in the base frame at one side of the wall into the concrete. As you roll that wall out, make sure your columns are perfectly spaced before you put your holes in the concrete to ensure perfect column spacing.
These are scalable, so the structure for the 30 by 30s are exactly the same as the structure for the 30 by 120s. So once you get one wall, you can just put it all the way through to the end of your greenhouse at whatever length you want.
We just built our first truss on the ground, did it up and placed it on the columns.
Got it.
We're now plumbing up all of our west wall columns and attaching them to the end wall, the end truss. Once that's all set, we'll start rolling the trusses out bay by bay.
So far on this particular project, we've got all of the 9 trusses up, and then we also have the 2 end walls up. And today we're going to put up the purlins and girts. Now girts are structural elements that fit into the side walls that we'll put the exterior panels onto. And that stiffens the structure to increase the snow load and shear wind load for your particular location. The purlins are the ones that go on the roof, so they stack all the way up the roofing structure. And again, we attach the roof, the polycarbonate, to the purlins. And then on the end walls, you can have the option of full insulated metal panels, which we attach onto the girts as well. And then I wanted to show one other thing, because we'll do this, depending on your structure, you're gonna have an entry door on one side, and you'll have an 8x8
overhead door and an entry door on the other side. And this is what we call a header for the door. This attaches just with L brackets. It attaches slightly above the door height so that you can fit the jamb inside a particular header. Today we're installing our prefabricated insulated wall panels on the north side. These help to reflect light that hits the back wall and create a super insulated and energy efficient structure. Greenhouses are designed to grow year-round, even in harsh climates. Our kits come with hail-resistant, well-insulated triple-wall polycarbonate, providing very high light transmission. Polycarbonate goes on with a triple-layer aluminum track system. Bottom track goes on first, has a couple of long black rubber gaskets. And on the top channel, there's matching long black rubber gaskets. And when you screw the top channel into the bottom channel, it just squeezes gently on the polycarbonate and compresses those gaskets, which keeps all the water from getting inside that gasket into the greenhouse. Finally, there's a little, about an inch wide clip that goes, fits into the top of the top aluminum channel. It's designed to be able to click into place. When you get out into the field, there's a little bit of dust, maybe some metal shavings, and the aluminum tends to expand. So once you get that top channel screwed in on the roof and it sits there in the sun, it expands and it makes it a little bit hard to click that top piece in. So what we do is they'll take a rag and they'll clean off all the dirt and they'll just slide it up all the way up to the north wall on the roof. At Ceres Greenhouse Solutions, we provide cutting-edge technologies to allow people to build net-zero energy greenhouses. Erecting a high-yield kit is much easier than a wood-framed greenhouse. Framing sections are pre-cut and ready to put together. That allows you to save money on the labor, whether you do it yourself or you have a licensed contractor. You'll be able to build our greenhouse in less time. Our high-yield kits make it easy for backyard growers, commercial farms, and schools. Anywhere you have space and a desire to grow your own sustainable, year-round source of food. Before you go, at Ceres Greenhouse Solutions, we're not just going to sell you a building and walk away. We're there during the design, the build, and the growing process.
We are Ceres Greenhouse Solutions.